Welcome to Project Poldergeist, an ongoing series of animated videos that plumb the complexities of life below sea level. I'm Poldergeist, and I'll be your host as we peer beneath the surface in the Netherlands and other coastal regions. Because when it comes to water in the Dutch, there's a lot more going on than meets the eye. The Dutch are amazing. They have a powerful story about living with water, and they're not afraid to let people know it. We've been waging war against water for centuries. We have water in our DNA. God created the world, but the Dutch created the Netherlands. Their storm surge barriers are legendary. Each one of those arms is as big as the Eiffel Tower. While coastal cities like Miami and Jakarta worry about sea level rise, the Dutch say, relax. We've been living below sea level forever. We've got you covered, and that's very reassuring. But how does it work? Parts of the Netherlands are like a big old empty swimming pool, with a shallow end and a deep end. At the shallow end, water comes in from some major rivers. We're talking major. Ever hear of the Rhine? But here's the thing. They don't fill the pool. Instead, the Dutch pull them through to the sea, leaving residents below. Along the coast, the deep end butts up against the North Sea. So there are dikes and dunes that keep the water out, and those barriers on the rivers in case of storm surge. And there's rain from above, land that subsides, and a water table that wants to rise from below, and a population that wants to keep its feet dry. That's where the pumps come in. They lift the water that collects below up into those rivers above that then drain into the sea. It takes a lot of ingenuity and energy to keep that big old swimming pool drained. Okay, now we understand how it works. But just how big is the Dutch swimming pool? I've often heard that 50% of the Netherlands is below sea level. That seems like a good number, half the country. But I wanted to be sure, so I did a little research. The NAP Foundation says that half of the Netherlands consists of polders that are below sea level. NAP is the name of that blue and white measuring rod that you see poking up out of canals and rivers all over the country. They ought to know, right? But I started to run into numbers that were even higher. In the 2007 IPCC report, it says 55% of the Netherlands is below sea level. But it doesn't stop there. The Consul General of the Netherlands in Miami, one of those coastal cities the Dutch want to save, was interviewed on national public radio. And get this, she said 80% of the country is below sea level, but it's really almost our whole country. I couldn't believe my ears. 80%? No, wait, really, almost the whole country. How is that even possible? Is the whole country like a drained swimming pool? Well, someone challenged the IPCC on their claim of 55%, and the IPCC said, okay, we'll look into it, and they located their source. Guess what? It was the Dutch government, their own environmental assessment agency. Oops. So how big is the Dutch swimming pool really? It's 26% of the country. That's it. Still a lot, but not half or three quarters or almost the whole country. So I have a question. How can a nation known for the precision of its water defense system come up with such crazy exaggerations? To find an answer, we're going to have to peer beneath the surface. Let's invite the Netherlands to lie down on Dr. Poldergeist's couch. Come here, take a load off. Now, in my opinion, these involuntary exaggerations of yours are symptoms. They're symptoms that emerge from the Dutch collective unconscious. What's the unconscious trying to tell us? I have two theories. Theory one, this is a display of bravado coupled with salesmanship. We're invincible. Why should we worry about sea level rise? The whole country's already below sea level. And by the way, could we interest you in a storm surge barrier? Theory two, anxiety, sheer panic. Oh my God, the whole country is below sea level and sea level rise is accelerating. We're going to drown in our own swimming pool. What are we going to do? I think both theories are right at one and the same time. Two sides of the same guilder, or euro. Don't get me wrong, the Dutch really are amazing. and we're going to need their adaptive ingenuity more than ever. But that means being honest about the climate emergency. After 2050, it may not be possible to keep the swimming pool drained, no matter how big it is. Accelerated sea level rise takes a whole new level of courage. Can the Dutch do what it takes? We'll be watching. I'm Poldergeist. You know where to find me. I'll be right here, peering beneath the surface. Because when it comes to water and the Dutch, there's more going on than meets the eye.